the Lord at all times. Hallelujah. And I like that third verse. It said, oh, magnify. Agape, come on and magnify the Lord with me on this morning. Because you know what? It could be worse. Glory to God. And I've made the decision. You've got to make the choice. You've got to decide within yourself to magnify God. No, is everything all the way I want it to be? No, 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 it's not. Glory to God. But I will magnify the Lord. Come on and magnify the Lord with me. The voice of deliverance say, have you tried Jesus? He's all right. You may have tried everything else, but if you only would try Jesus, he's the answer. Jesus is the answer to every situation. Hallelujah. Why don't you call him right now? Just say Jesus right where you are, right while you're sitting wherever you are. Just say Jesus, Jesus, the answer, Jesus. He is the answer, Jesus. He is the answer. The government is not the answer. Come on now. The governor is not the answer. The president of the USA is not the answer. But Jesus, woo, glory to God. He is the answer. He is the answer. I'm feeling happy as eloquent say. I feel like picking them up, putting them down. Glory to God. Because this I said, well, Pastor, you don't have any music at home up above my head. I hear music in the air. Glory to God, glory to God. Jesus is the answer. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's something about the name of Jesus. Amen. We certainly thank God for our online audience. Thank God for those of you who are on Zoom on this morning. And we want you, this is the time now to give of your tithes and offering. If you're looking via Facebook, there's a tagline that's strolling at the bottom of your screen that you can give to be a blessing to this ministry, to this ministry. Hallelujah. Those Agape membership, it's now time to give of your tithes and offering. If this is your tithing period, give of your tithes, give your tithes, give your offering. This is good ground. We are accountable for every penny that comes into the Agape Church. Amen. You can pull the records. You can look at the records. We are accountable to what comes into the Agape Church. Let's be a blessing to the ministry. You can give through Giblify. You just have to search on the church's name, Agape Deliverance, COGIC, or through Cash App, $AGAPECOGIC20. Let's be givers. Let's give on this morning. We're getting ready now to hear from heaven. Amen. Today, our very own evangelist, Tarnetta Randall, evangelist Tarnetta Randall, is going to come and share the word of the Lord. And this is a powerful woman of God. She is a prayer warrior. She's always prayed up and ready to pray for you. Amen. She is the wife of our vice chair of our deacon board, Deacon Victor Randall. We thank God for the entire Randall family. Amen. The children and the grandchildren, grandmother, mother and all. We thank God for them. But before she shall come and share the word of the Lord, I keep hearing it down in my spirit that somebody needs to say Jesus. You tried everything else. You cried. Many have cried all night long. Many of you have been frustrated. You don't know which way to go. But I'm telling you now, if you will only call Jesus. I just keep hearing that ringing down that somebody need to call Jesus. No need to call grandma. No need to call auntie. No need to call mama, but right where you are, you need to call Jesus. Your anxiety is on number 10. You need to call Jesus. He's an anxiety fixer. Hallelujah. If there's chaos all around, call Jesus. He is the answer that you need. But before Evangelist Randall should come, we're going to ask, we're going to go back into our video archives, and our diamonds, our little babies, is going to come. And that's to he wants it all. Who want it all? Jesus want it all. He don't want you half-stepping. He don't want you part-time with him and part-time with the enemy. But Jesus wants it all. The diamonds of the Agape Deliverance Church of God in Christ.
Yes. Glory to God. 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 Like Pastor said this morning, somebody needs to call on the name of Jesus because he wants it all. No half stepping. He wants it all. So we give glory. We give glory. We give glory and honor to our Father, who has been so faithful and so kind and so merciful to us. Now, Father God, in the blessed name of your one and only Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus, Father God, here is the time to bring forth your preached word. Father God, it is certainly not about me, not about us, but God, it is about all of you on this morning. It is about your glory, that your glory, oh God, will be revealed in the lives of your people, oh God. So Father God, I ask that you will use me on this morning as your chosen vessel for this message, oh God. Father God, it's certainly not about me, but I want you to get all the glory, oh God. Let not the light shine on me, oh God, but let it shine completely and totally on you, oh God. Father God, please let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, oh God, let it be acceptable in your sight, oh God, because I want to live that life that is pleasing. I want to give it all to you, oh God. I want to continue to say yes, Lord, to your will. Yes, Lord, to your way, despite of. Now, Father God, send forth your word, oh God. Let it be an anointed word, oh God, that somebody needs to hear on this morning, oh God, so that your people can be reminded of exactly who you are, not who we are, but who you are, oh God, so that you can continue, oh God, to get the glory. You can continue, oh God, to get all the honor, and oh God, that you can continue to get the praise. We thank you for this place. We thank you for this space. We thank you for this opportunity that you have allowed for us to even carry your word, to minister to your people, your sheep, oh God. So we just bless you on this morning, oh God. We give you glory. Father God, we give you the highest honor and we give you the highest praise. Father God, it's in your Son Jesus' name do I pray to you on this morning. Amen and amen. We certainly thank God for another glorious day, another day that he has made that we can continue to rejoice. I tell you, Pastor, I'm right along with you. I have been rejoicing all morning, despite of there is a song above my head. I'm telling you, if I didn't walk through this room this morning, not because I had to prepare myself for anything, but I wanted to be sanctified. I wanted to be saturated. I wanted to be used for his glory. Not that anybody will see me or think it's all about me and the words that I speak, but only I understand only because it is in him I live, I move, and I have my being. So I certainly thank God for this time. I thank Pastor you, I thank Pastor, for always allowing us to come before your people, the people God has placed you over, to bring forth a word. That just goes to show that you serve a God that you trust, and you trust the God that's in me. And I certainly thank you. This is a privilege. I count this as a privilege always to be able to speak what thus says the Lord to the people that God has placed under you. And we also give honor to our assistant pastor on this morning. We celebrate you, man of God. Continue to move, continue to be blessed, continue to let God use you in these last and evil days. But I'm going to go ahead and go into the word, because I tell you, if I don't get into it, I may not have my Facebook or my Zoom etiquette, because I know how I can get. So I'll try to keep myself down and I'll get off the Zoom and I'll praise them like I'm gone and lost my everlasting mind. But this morning, if you will go with me to the book of Isaiah, we're going to come from chapter 7, verses 1 through 14. And if you can bear with me, I'm kind of struggling here with my laptop kind of went out on me. So I had to get Tyree's iPad and I'm fumbling here, trying to hold all this stuff. But nevertheless, to God be the glory. Isaiah 7, verses 1 through 14, and it reads as thus. When Ahaz, son of Jotham, the son of Uzziah, was king of Judah, King Rezin of Aram and Pekah, son of Remaliah, king of Israel, marched up to fight against Jerusalem. but they could not overpower it. Now the house of David was told, Aram has allied itself with Ephraim. So the hearts of Ahaz and his people were shaken, as the trees of the forest are shaken by the wind. Then the Lord said to Isaiah, go out, you and your son Shear-Jashub, to meet Ahaz at the end of the aqueduct of the upper pool on the road to the launderer's field. Say to him, be careful, keep calm, and don't be afraid. Do not lose heart because of these two smoldering stubs of firewood, because of the fierce anger of Rezin and Aram and of the son of Remaliah. Ephraim and Remaliah's son have plotted your ruin, saying, let us invade Judah. Let us tear it apart and divide it among ourselves and make the son of Tibeah king over it. Yet this is what the sovereign Lord says. It will not take place. It will not happen. For the head of Aram is Damascus, and the head of Damascus is only Rezin. Within 65 years, Ephraim will be too shattered to be a people. The head of Ephraim is Samaria, and the head of Samaria is only Remaliah's son. If you do not stand firm in your faith, you will not stand at all. Again, the Lord spoke to Ahaz, ask the Lord your God for a sign, whether in the deepest depths or in the highest heights. But Ahaz said, I would not ask. I would not put the Lord to the test. Then Isaiah said, hear now, you house of David, is it not enough to try the patience of humans? Will you try the patience of my God also? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and we'll call him Emmanuel. We certainly thank God for the reading of his word on this morning. We bless his holy name. But I will take a topic from that scripture on this morning. And that topic on this morning will be called, and he shall be called. Amen. And he shall be called. There are times when we find it hard to trust God to look after us. There are times when we think our situation is so bad, there's no way out. There are other times when we think we know the best solution to our problems, so we don't bother to ask God for help. All three of those statements were true of Ahaz. As Jerusalem lay surrounded by the armies of Israel and Syria, it looked like Jerusalem was doomed. The people were starving, and there didn't seem to be much hope unless they were rescued by another nation. In fact, Ahaz had it in his mind to form an alliance with Egypt or Assyria. Maybe that would solve their problems. In the case of Ahaz, God decides to help him out. He sends Isaiah to speak to him and say, be careful, keep calm, and don't be afraid. Do not lose heart because of these two smoldering stubs of firewood. Ahaz could relax in the face of this threat because God was with him. This was God's city, and he wasn't going to let these almost burnt out enemies take it captive. In fact, he tells him that Israel will be gone within 65 years. Now, I know many may be saying that this is a message we typically hear around Christmas or the Advent season, read along with Matthew verses 1 and 20, chapter 1, verse 23, during that time. But I tell you, saints of God, after the past months I've had, I needed to be reminded that God said that he is with us. Who would have thought that we would be right here, back at this spot, attending church virtually? Who would have thought that so many of us, even though vaccinated, would have contracted COVID? So many, including myself, had put some type of hope or trust in the health system that we were at least 98% protected from this virus after receiving a vaccination. Through these past few years, there have been so many challenges and difficulties for all of us. But I'm here on this morning, saints of God, to remind you of the God that we serve, who said that he is with us. First, he is holy. He said in 1 Peter 1:16, "You shall be holy, for I am holy." He is unique. In Isaiah 45:5, he declares that "I am the Lord, and there is none else. There is no God beside me." He is eternal. Before the mountains were born, or you gave birth to the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. He is omniscient. I'm sorry, he's omniscient. Psalms 147:4-5 says, "He counts the number of the stars. He gives names to all of them. Great is our Lord and abundant in strength. His understanding is infinite. He is omnipotent." Job said that God's power is so great that we cannot come near him. He is righteous and just in his dealings with us. He is omnipresent. David asked the question, "Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, you are there." He is a sovereign God. And the Bible says in Isaiah 46:9-10, "Remember the former things long past, for I am God and there is no other. I am God and there is no one like me. My purpose will be established and I will accomplish all my good pleasure." I know someone may be saying on this morning, why all the scriptures? Well, God is speaking this word on his word on this morning. It is not what I have to say, but what God has to say to his people. It is not about us on this glorious day, but it is all about him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. See, I think a lot of us have forgotten about the God we serve. We have robbed him of his glory and don't even realize it. We say with our mouths, "Glory be to God," but do we truly mean it in our hearts? Psalm 53:1 says, "The fool has said in his heart, there is no God." Oh no, but not here. You see, I know the God I serve, and he's revealing himself to me more and more each day. Remember Hagar, you know Sarah's Egyptian handmaid that she gave to be with her husband Abraham, and out of that union, Ishmael was conceived, which caused Sarah to despise Hagar, and because she was treated so badly by Sarah, she ran away into the desert. And it was there that God spoke to her and helped her. So she called him Elroi, the God who sees. We all know or have heard of the story of Genesis chapter 22. Abraham, when told to offer his son Isaac as a burnt offering, and right before he was about to slay his son, the angel of the Lord stopped him. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, there was a ram caught in the bush. So Abraham called that place Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides. He is Jehovah Makadeshkim, the God who sanctifies. He is Jehovah Nisi, the God who gives us the victory. He is Jehovah Rapha, the God who healeth thee. He is Jehovah Rohi, the God that takes care of you. He is Jehovah Shalom, the God that defeats our enemies to bring us peace. He is Jehovah Sidkenu, the God of my righteousness. I believe King David knew God all too well because he quoted just that in Psalms 23. "The Lord is my shepherd. He is Jehovah Rohi because he takes care of me. I shall not want. He is Jehovah Jireh because he provides for me. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He is Jehovah Shalom because he keeps me in perfect peace. He restores my soul. He is Jehovah Rapha because he healeth me. He leadeth me in the path paths of righteousness for his name's sake. He is Jehovah Tsidkenu because he is my righteousness. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will not fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. I say he is Jehovah Nissi because he gives me the victory. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever, because he is Jehovah Makadeshkema, because he sanctifies me. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. I'm telling you, people of God, we got to know the God that we serve. If we say that he is God, we got to know that he is God. I tell you, even on this morning, when I was sitting here and I was preparing my heart, I was preparing my mind, I was preparing myself, because I know he said, he told me months ago, he did not say, be still. He said, I am commanding you to be still and know that I am God. We got too much stress going on. We worry about this, that, and the other thing, what we can control, what we cannot control. Our pastor has been teaching us on distractions. There is an enemy of your soul who walks around like a prowling lion, roaring, seeking, picking off whom he can devour. But I come to serve notice on him this morning, that I know the God that I serve. We call him Jehovah Jireh because we know he provides. We call him Jehovah Rapha because despite of it all, despite of the sickness, despite of the disease, despite of the infirmity, despite of COVID, we know that he is the God who healeth thee. And if I can back up a little bit, because I'm telling you, God is so faithful. God is faithful to his people. Even sitting here this morning, when I was rereading this message, trying to make sure that I didn't mess up or I didn't do anything wrong, God said, be still. Be still. I'm God. I'm going to get the glory. I shall get the glory. But he took me back to Isaiah, the same chapter 7. But I looked at verse 9, and I looked at that thing, and I looked at it, and I looked at it again. And it said, and mine was coming from the NIV. It says, if you do not stand firm in your faith, you will not stand at all. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. People of God, you better remember what Hebrews 11:6 says. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is. So if we don't believe that God is who he said he is, if we don't believe, and that's what our faith is, believing God is who he said he is. It says, if you do not stand firm in your faith, believing that God is who he said he is, you will not stand at all. So people of God, I'm just here on this morning with a message of hope, with a message of encouragement, because it blessed my socks off. It blessed my very soul this morning when I sat in this room and I read and I read and I looked. And he spoke. He said, if you do not stand firm in your faith, you will not stand at all. He said, you got to believe that I'm God. And if I said it, I'm going to do it, it shall come to pass. He said he sends his word out. And whatever he sent his word to do, it's going to be accomplished. He watches over his word that it shall not return to him void. So if God has promised you healing, you shall be healed. He said he's Jehovah Rapha. If he said he's going to provide for you, he's Jehovah Jireh. He is our provider. But saints of God, we got to know the God that we serve is able to do. He said he's able to do exceeding and abundantly above all that we can ask or even begin to think. Our minds and our thoughts and our ways are not his ways, not his thoughts. God is the one who gives life. He is our creator. He is our father. But we got to stand on his word. We got to say, if we say we walk by faith, we got to believe that God is who he said he is. And the second part of that says, he is a rewarder. He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. You can't seek him today and don't seek him tomorrow. Glory be to God. You can't seek him Monday and don't seek him Tuesday. You can't seek him Tuesday. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You can't seek him when you need him. You got to seek him when you feel like you don't need him. You got to seek him when all your bank account is straight. You got to seek him when your refrigerator is full. You got to seek him when you got health in your body, when you got the activities of your limbs. You got to seek him when you're in your rightful mind. Don't wait till the storm comes to seek God. He said those who diligently seek him. Seek him in the morning. Seek him in the noonday. Seek him when you land there at night and know that he is God. And beside him, there is absolutely no other. Nobody like the God we serve. Not that he's got to prove himself to any of us, but God has proven himself faithful. He's proven himself, he even kept us. I know all of us have been vaccinated for the most part, but it won't about the vaccine. Because we could have left up out of here just like anybody else. But because of God's faithfulness to his people, if he said he's going to do it, stand on his word, stand on his promises, because we serve a God. We serve a God who is able to do exactly what it is that he said he's going to do. We walk around worrying about too much, even myself. Worrying about too much. How is this going to get done? And it's just a distraction. And Pastor, I thank you. I thank you for being led by God and being led by the Spirit that you are teaching on distractions. Even in our jurisdictional meeting yesterday, that man said something about distractions. And I just said, glory to God, glory to God. If God's people have not been distracted by everything, even by COVID, we worry about who got it, who going to get it, what's happening. When God didn't kept us, I know protocols are in place. Everything is in place. And our pastor, I thank you for doing what God is telling you to do, woman of God, concerning the people he put you over. But we worry about everything and we get so off focus. We're not looking to God. We're not believing God is who he say he is. He can speak the word and this thing will be eradicated. All he got to do is speak the word. But it has to be according to his will. We said, oh God, let your will be done. Not our will, but let your will be done. When we really truly, those words that we speak out of our mouth, when they really truly penetrate our heart and what we say, not just for cliche or just because we know how to say those things, but when we truly, truly know the God that we serve, we can say, God, let thine will be done despite of, if it don't go my way, if it don't go the way I've prayed, let your will be done, oh God, and I will be satisfied. Teach me how to be abased. Teach me how to be satisfied with your will, not our will, oh God, but let your will be done. Oh, we pray that prayer, but do we truly believe that God's will needs to be done? God is going to get his glory. God, it will get his glory, even if he get it without us. But I said, Lord, don't pass me back. Let me be in the number. Let me serve you till I die. Let me serve you like never before, oh God, because he deserves it, saints. He gets all the glory. If it had not been for him, if it had not been for the Lord, who was always, ever on our sides, where will we be on this day? This is the day that the Lord has made. We didn't make it. He told us to rejoice. And again, he said, rejoice and be glad because we are here and we have him as our God. We can cry out, Abba Father, to our God.
We know he is Jehovah, the great Jehovah that he is. There is nobody like Jehovah. Nobody like Jehovah. Absolutely no God like the God we serve. I listened to that young lady on my job, and she stood around, new girl. I said, to God be the glory. Devil, you a liar. Devil, you are a liar. Sitting back there with me, telling something, I believe there is a higher power. I believe there is a God. I know the God we serve. So many people believe in all the stuff, what they want to believe in. But I tell you, it's going to come a day. It's going to come a day. And it is not that they're going to have to turn to the God that we serve. The only God that can save. The only God that can deliver. The only God that can heal. The only God that can make a way where there seemed to be no way. The only God that can open up a door and close one at the same time. The only God that we can lean and depend on. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. I will not stop giving him his praise. I shall not stop saying hallelujah. Glory to the wonderful name of Jesus. We just thank God on this morning. We give glory to God. We don't just say those things just to be saying them, but we give glory to our Father because we know he alone is deserving of it. So I just thank you all this morning. I just celebrate God. I just love on him on this morning. There is absolutely safe. I'm telling you, absolutely no God like the God we serve. Every time I turn around, somebody texting me or somebody saying they positive for COVID. But I said, to God be the glory. We're still here. We're still breathing because those light afflictions, huh? That little light symptoms we had, to God be the glory. To God be the glory. And I'm not trying to put my family out there, but to even the ones who have not been vaccinated, they could have been taken out of here. But to God, I know what I'm going to see. To God, what I'm going to say, to God be the glory. To God be the glory that he keeps sustaining life. And it is my request to those on this morning, if you don't know him, if you don't know him, you better get to know him before it's too late. You better get to know the God that we can call on, the God who can send down rain in a dry place, the God that can send down healing when he said the effectual, fervent prayers of the righteous avail as much. The God who hears our prayers, the God who answers our prayers is no God like the God we serve. God bless you. We're going to turn this back over into the hands of our pastor. Before we go, I'm sorry, let me finish this up because I tell you, I get so excited when talking about the goodness of God, but glory to God. Anyway, so I'm telling you, I'm challenging you. I know that scripture that he shall be called has been read during Christmas time and during the Advent season, but saints of God, in Matthew, verses 1 and 23. And it says, and he shall be called Emmanuel, which being interpreted, God with us. God with us. God is truly with us. So let's not wait for the Christmas season to know that God is with us. God bless each and every one of you. Pastor, I've turned it back over into your hands, woman of God.
Glory to God. Glory to God. God is with us. And he shall be called Emmanuel, meaning God is with us. She says something about be careful, be calm, and do not be afraid, because the God that we serve is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. And I told you before that someone need to call Jesus. And she said that he shall be called. And right now, where you are, I'm going to pray And if you had not accepted the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior, all you had to do is call him. Father God, we thank you. We thank you for the word of the Lord. We thank you for this vessel that brought forth such a powerful word. Father, now we are praying for those who have not accepted you as Lord and Savior. And right now, God, come into their hearts. Cleanse them. Come into their minds. In the name of Jesus, help them to call on your name. Oh, God. Those who have not accepted Jesus, just say, Father, forgive me of all my sins. I want to receive you into my life. Wash me up, clean me up. I accept you as Lord and Savior. And I tell you now, if you said that prayer, all you have to do is to tell God, thank you. When you have received the gift, and salvation is a gift, all you have to do is say, thank you. Thank you, Lord, for coming into my life. You may not say, well, I don't feel anything. Believe. Believe. Open up your mouth and confess. Romans 10 and 9. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in your heart, thou shalt be saved. Confess now, I am saved, and I accept you as my Lord and Savior. God bless you. God bless you. We certainly thank God for the word of the Lord on today.